Hello everyone, today we are going to present on scoliosis and kyphosis. For definition, scoliosis is a medical condition in which a person's spine has a sideways curve. The curve is usually S or C shape over three dimensions. In some, the degree of curve is stable, while in others, it increases over time. Prevalence in Malaysia. A previous study done in Malaysia has reported school scoliosis screening with a total of 8,966 students. The result showed the prevalence rate of scoliosis was 2.55% and scoliosis was more common amongst females. Etiology. Common causes that doctors may identify include cerebral palsy, muscular dystrophy, birth defects, infections, tumors, and genetic conditions like Marfan syndrome and Down syndrome. Clinical features. Symptoms of scoliosis include curved posture, uneven hips or waist, one shoulder blade that looks bigger, nerve damage that causes numbness in feet, height reduction due to a curved spine, humped back, leaning towards one side, protruding rib, and shortness of breath caused by upper spine curve. Pathophysiology of scoliosis include embryological malformation of one or more vertebrae that occur in any location of the spine, vertebral abnormalities that causes one area of the spinal column lengthens at a slower rate than the rest, and spine arthritis known as spondylosis that weakens the ligaments of the spine. Clinical investigations. Scoliosis can be diagnosed through first, X-ray to observe the structure of the vertebrae, second, MRI to see the spinal cord and the surrounding areas, third, CT scan to observe the shape and size of the spinal canal, and fourth, COPS method to quantify spine curvature. There are two types of medical management: conservative, which is bracing, and surgical, which is spinal fusion. The first one is bracing. Braces won't straighten the spine, but they can prevent the curvature from increasing. This method of treatment is more effective for cases that are detected early. There are two main types of braces. The first one is underarm braces that made of plastic and fitting close to the body. This brace is virtually invisible. It is used to treat lower spine curves and fits around the lower part of the body. The second one is Milwaukee braces. This brace starts at the neck and covers the entire torso, with the exception of the legs and arms. It's used for curves that the underarm brace can address. Next is surgery. Surgery is usually reserved for people with curve greater than 40 degrees. Spinal fusion is the standard scoliosis surgery. In this procedure, the doctor fuses the vertebrae together using a bone graft, roots, and screws. The roots keep your spine in a straight position and the screws hold them in place. The prognosis of scoliosis can vary immensely according to the degree of the spinal deformity. A curve of fewer than 20 degrees can be described as mild scoliosis, and the prognosis for this condition is positive. While a curve greater than 70 degrees can be described as severe scoliosis and the prognosis is negative. Impairments and functional limitations include difficulty to breathe, chronic back pain, difficulty sitting or standing, and difficulty walking due to loss of leg muscle coordination.
Okay, now let's talk about kyphosis. Do you know what kyphosis is? The definition of kyphosis, it is also known as round back or hunchback. It is a condition in which the spine in the upper back has an excessive curvature. Kyphosis can affect patients of all ages, however, it is common during adolescence. As for incident and prevalence, report of prevalence and incident of hyperkyphosis in older adults vary from approximately 20% to 40% among both men and women. Abnormal vertebrae can be caused by fractures, osteoporosis, degeneration, Schirman disease, birth defects, and syndromes. Kyphosis often occurs without any other symptom. However, other symptoms can include mild to severe back pain with movement, fatigue, tenderness and stiffness in the spine, forward posture of head, chest pain or difficulty breathing, difference in shoulder height, tight hamstring. Exact pathophysiology is unknown, but there are several theories. The first one is osteonecrosis of anterior apophyseal ring, herniation of disc material leading to loss of anterior disc height, relative osteoporosis lead to compression deformity, and the last one is altered biomechanics lead to anterior wedging and subsequent growth arrest. As for management, there are two, which is conservative and surgical. One is observation, second NSAID including aspirin, ibuprofen and naproxen, and the last one is bracing. For surgical management, spinal fusion is the surgical procedure most commonly used to treat kyphosis. The goal of spinal fusion are to reduce the degree of curve, prevent any further progression, maintain the improvement over time, and the last one alleviate significant back pain if it is present. for prognosis, the majority of patients are successfully treated with conservative measure. Patients with kyphotic curve less than 60 degrees at skeletal maturity typically have no long-term sequelae. Let's move to impairment and functional limitation, physical complication, body image, back pain, loss of normal bladder control, decreased appetite, and the last one is problem with sense of balance. These are the references that we use. That's all from us. Thank you.